In 1970, she helped found the Feminist Press. It was hailed for making available a legacy of writings by and about women. Florence Howe, a key architect of the women's studies movement and a founder of the Feminist Press, a literary nonprofit dedicated to promoting social justice and amplifying overlooked voices, died on Saturday in Manhattan. She was 91. The Feminist Press confirmed her death in a statement. Ms. Howe, who lived on Manhattan's Upper West Side, had been in hospice care with Parkinson's disease, which was diagnosed in 2017. When Ms. Howe began teaching in colleges and universities in the 1950s, women's studies was not an established academic discipline. In fact, it was rare to find a course catalog or syllabus that mentioned scholarship by women at all. With the Feminist Press, founded in 1970, she sought to diversify the materials used in schools around the United States and beyond. She and her husband, Paul Lauder, were professors and knew firsthand that there was a gender gap in the books being taught. I was teaching women's studies at Goucher College in Maryland at the time, and there weren't enough materials, Ms. Howe told the New York Times in 1972. The publishers I spoke to all said, "Wonderful idea, but there's no money in it." Mr. Lauder suggested that they publish the books themselves and came up with the name The Feminist Press. It sounded magical, Ms. Howe said. The Feminist Press began as a modest DIY endeavor. Board meetings were run out of the couple's big yellow house in the Mount Washington neighborhood of Baltimore. And when Ms. Howe left Goucher for the State University of New York College at Old Westbury, now SUNY Old Westbury, in 1971, she brought the publishing house with her. The college, on Long Island, had agreed to house and support it. More than a decade later, Joseph Duffy, a former chairman of the National Endowment for the Humanities, wrote in the New York Times Book Review that the Feminist Press had perhaps more than any other institution helped to recover and make available a legacy of writing by and about women in American history and scholarship. Authors whose titles have been published or republished by the Feminist Press include Zora Neale Hurston, Charlotte Perkins Gilman, Barbara Ehrenreich, Willa Cather, Alice Walker, and the members of the Russian feminist performance group Pussy Riot. I would say we started what has become an avalanche of the rediscovery of women writers, Ms. Howe told the Baltimore Sun in 1993. We're not the only one who does this now. The article called her the mother of women's studies. Florence Rosenfeld was born on March 17, 1929, in Brooklyn to Samuel and Frances Rosenfeld. During the Great Depression, her father abandoned his dream of opening a home furnishings store and became a taxi driver to support the family. Her mother was a bookkeeper until Florence's birth and later worked for an aeronautics manufacturer. She hoped that her daughter would become a teacher. The family, including a son, Jack, moved frequently in 1930s for financial reasons to Hoboken, New Jersey, the Bronx and elsewhere in Brooklyn. In 1943, Florence was admitted to Hunter College High School in Manhattan, ranked among the top public schools in the country. She graduated early and enrolled at Hunter College, the place in which I learned to think, she wrote in a memoir, A Life in Motion, 2011. Her activist spirit was also ignited as a Hunter undergraduate. She formed an interracial and interfaith sorority with friends and was elected student body president. She studied English with the intention of teaching in the public school system, but was encouraged by a professor and Hunter's president to pursue a master's degree, which she earned at Smith College. In 1951, she went on to study for a doctorate in English at the University of Wisconsin. Within 6 years, she married three times and took the surname of one of those husbands, Ed Howe. She married Paul Lauder in the 1960s, they divorced in 1987. After 3 years of study at Wisconsin, Ms. Howe moved back to New York to teach at Hofstra College, now a university, and Queens College. She moved to Baltimore in...
don't tell me, don't tell me why. I know, no, no, you won't save my life.